When I decided I wanted to be a neurosurgeon, I was 12. I had an idea, which was crazy at that time because I didn't know what I was signing up for. Several years later, my parents were like, if you can translate it, we will be your biggest advocates and supporters. And I got into med school before I knew it, and I was the youngest medical student in my class. I was not even 17 at the time. Unfortunately, I lost my father in the process. We went through a lot of difficulty to even sustain my medical school tuition, but she said, if you believe in something, I will believe in you and I will make it happen. And I didn't even know what she was doing to make it happen. I was just a teenager. In retrospect, that was everything they had. I knew within myself that I'm meant to be a neurosurgeon, and that is what I want to do. I define what my future looks like and what I'm willing to invest to make it.
I think this is really important. It sets the tone of how hard you're willing to work and how much you're striving to achieve with your lives.
I think it's interesting because everyone that goes into this field, I feel like, has a high amount of ambition towards becoming a neurosurgeon without having any clue what neurosurgery is actually going to feel like. I mean, you don't even have a clue when you start residency, really, and we're still all learning what that is going to mean for each and every one of us. And I think it's different for everyone, what your ambition is towards this field, and I think you have to learn that as you get through residency. I don't think anyone's ambition is to be a junior resident.
Ambition is this really dynamic trait that everyone who's here has it. When you're in medical school and you're thinking about going into neurosurgery, there's nothing more higher on the rung to reach for, so you're naturally ambitious because you're willing to commit 7 years, you're willing to compete for a spot that's 1 to 3. You have to be ambitious. I've seen people who I always thought were ambitious and watched their ambition just stop or die. And then, you know, all of a sudden, that resident who wrote 75 papers as a resident didn't write a single paper after he graduated. Or that resident who was just eating up cases and doing as much as they could find just disappeared into some practice somewhere and you never heard from them again. I do think it's a really dynamic thing. I think it's one of those really important traits to keep you climbing and trying to reach your goals, whatever they may be.
You guys are both hockey players. It's Wayne Gretzky's line, right? Skating to where the puck's going, not to where the puck is. And so through innovation, but also a combination of being open and ready for when opportunities arise, to be in that position where when the next thing happens, they want it to be done here. And I think that's what we've experienced.
That's the beauty of ambition, is when you have it, it becomes part of your being. You're always looking for that next thing. You're always looking for where the puck's gonna go so that you can be the one who picks up the puck out of the corner and get there. Ambition's tough. We meet so many medical students who wanna come here, and a lot of them strike us as being super driven and super ambitious, but it's not always sustained.
It's brutal. Our work hours, our lifestyle, all of this is different than the normal society. And everybody knows that and is willing to do that gladly, because there is a hidden reward to this in seeing your patients do better. But there's also that drive, that this purpose, that I am one of the few people who is willing to sacrifice other aspects of my life to do this, and I'm good at it, or I'm learning to be good at it.
When I think of ambition, I think of finding a purpose that's going to inform and motivate and drive all the actions that follow. Maintaining that ambition is really about keeping that as a North Star that you never let go of.
To me, ambition is just a function of what my goal or mission is. If you have a passion for whatever that mission is, then ambition's the natural progression of that. And so, you know, for me, the reason I went into neurosurgery is because my mom had brain cancer and she had a lot of neurosurgical needs, and I grew up largely in the neurosurgical ICU, and so thought it was incredible what those providers were doing, and so I became singularly focused on curing brain cancer in many ways. And so whether that's in the OR, whether that's in the lab, that drives my ambition. I think that maybe that can be a function of people's ambition changing, is maybe their missions change in life as far as what becomes spiritually fulfilling to them. So that's kind of a natural progression of how ambition evolves.
It's very hard to have ambition if you don't know where you're going with it, and it's not productive. And so I think the big thing is, what is your vision?
Helping somebody and giving hope to people, and that ability to be in that pivotal moment of these people's experience, their lives, their condition, when they have to give themselves to the hands of a stranger, and to bridge that gap from being a stranger to being somebody that they're ready to trust. That's one of the biggest privileges of what we do, and we get to do it at such an extreme space of the brain. And, you know, it's that ambition that kind of gets us through the door to become neurosurgeons. But then it's part of that pivot of it's all about the patient, the caring, the commitment to our patients, the courage to be their guide through this moment in their lives, I think is what, to me, really kind of keeps me going.
Ambition seems like an amorphous drive to accomplish something or to do extraordinary things, but it seems kind of empty if it's not connected to a purpose. And so you can have this drive to do something, but that ambition is basically impossible to be maintained if it's not connected to a purpose.
It's like this flame that you have to constantly work at preserving or kindling. And if you lose the flame, your whole life changes. It's like the course all of a sudden veers.
You know, being really hungry in the operating room or really enjoying the experience of the OR, like that challenge, like the environment, like the team mentality that exists there. That's what I have an ambition for, but I don't think I could have told you that just coming into neurosurgery. I don't even think that I really recognized how much of a team sport it was until I got a few years in to really experience what that means and how much that drives a surgical success story. So I think it's an evolving thing.
Picture yourself 10 years from now, what is the most successful version of myself at that point, and then just kind of work backwards.
My ambition during training was really just to focus on becoming like as skilled technically as I could be, really with kind of the motivation behind that being like to give whoever I may be taking care of at the time really the best chance.
I want to make an impact on my profession. I've dedicated all these years to doing something special and to working and building and advancing neurosurgery. I want to have that impact.
There's a transition from ambition to stewardship. Stewardship for our field of neurosurgery, our hospital, our group, our department, you know, our residents, that this continues to be a place where people come to learn neurosurgery at the forefront.
Basically making everything patient-centric. That's a purpose that you can continuously go back to and continuously like makes you strive to push yourself and attain more.
I mean, you've got to have drive, right? So that drive needs to be directed in the appropriate direction, right? So drive, integrity, and compassion.
I want to make a difference. I sacrificed everything that everyone in my life had and put everything into this one pot. I always remind myself of what they were willing to sacrifice, and I owe it to them and to myself to give it a shot.
Not everybody has that overarching ambition or that thing that they're striving to bring into the world. And whether it's a surgeon or a politician, an athlete, or a leader of some kind, they have that, and the courage follows them.
If you just chase the goddess of wisdom, the goddess of money will come after you. You know, pursue the right values, pursue the right thing, pursue wisdom, pursue integrity, pursue mission, purpose, and everything else will kind of work itself out.